Hello Taurus, this is your taroscopes for the month of June 2019. I'm using a couple of different decks now. I have the Rider Waite ones that I usually use in the one-to-one readings, but I'm also using as well a friend of mine, Rachel Patterson. Several years ago she designed some cards and they're currently herb cards, so I'm also going to be using those to give you a bit of more support, and also my favourite angel cards. Now, although I think they're Doreen Virtue ones, and she's gone off the wall, a little bit, I still actually like the cards. So I shall see what we've got for you, Taurus. Now, I'm a Taurus, so this will be interesting. So we're looking at June. First card for you, Taurus. This is all about communication for me. This is about speaking the truth. There could be some harsh words. There could be some harsh words with another female coming up. Arguments, confrontations. But it's asking me to speak the truth. It's telling me that there's not enough clarification around the situation. And things are very mixed up. Things are very muddled. So you need to speak the truth. But there could also be a little bit of harsh tones coming in here as well. And a bit of arguments. So being Taurus, you probably won't want to just blurt things out straight away. You'll probably hold things back a little bit and then all of a sudden say them. So just be careful how you say them, because obviously you don't want you to lose control with that. But it is asking you to speak with clarity, speak the clear truth. If there's a situation going on around you at the moment, Taurus, then be mindful that there is probably things going on around that aren't so honest, and there is maybe some situations going on in your mind that are a little bit mixed up at the moment. But this card says that there will be a bit of a breakthrough coming from it, and you know, as you know, the truth always comes out. Now, the next part of the month as you move forward, rest and relaxation. Rest and recuperation. It's saying you need to have some time out. You need to step back from things, step back from either the argument or whatever it is that's bothering you. Take some time out to rest, recuperate, and that's going to allow you to come back stronger. Now, I'm really fortunate that I do have a holiday this month, so that's perfect for me. Both of you are for it, so hopefully it's a good for you, Taurus. What it's saying is just step out of anything that is bothering you, particularly something that might be really on your mind. You could have a couple of different things, but there could be something that's really taking your focus, and interestingly, are those swords, and that's mental in your mind. So just take a step back, recuperate, have some time out, and you will come back feeling a lot stronger. And as you move forward, lovely, as you move forward until the end of the month there for June, you have abundance coming, your hard work paying off, fruition, and although it's slow progress, you've got it. It's talking about being independent, keeping yourself to yourself a little bit, keeping your financial situation to yourself. Anything to do with money, I usually say when this card pops up that people need to be a bit careful about not sharing it out and letting people pay their way, that type of thing. Keep independent with anything that you're doing at the moment, obviously. Keep things a little bit close to your chest, which you normally be good at. It is saying though that your hard work will pay off and that there is fruits of your labour coming and abundance. Now, I know we're talking about June, but I'm also feeling September is going to be an abundant time for you, Tauruses. There could also be connections around abroad, properties or investments or holiday home this month as well, Taurus, for you. But either way, it's full of abundance that's coming after this respite, so you really will come back fully charged and ready to take action and have your fruits of your labour coming in. Now, from Rachel's cards, Taurus, let's see what we've got from you. Oh, do you know what? That's my favourite carnation. That is actually my favourite, so I'm loving that. I don't know these cards off by heart, and I'm just going to go with what I get. So pink is all about love. Pink is about self-love as well, unconditional love. And it actually says healing, strength and courage. So Tauruses, if you're probably needing some of this at the moment, some healing, some strength, some courage. And the carnation for me, it was my great granny's favourite flower, And that's where I've taken my name, May, from as well, because that was her middle name, as well as my birthday name and my godmother's middle name from her. So the carnation's got a very strong link to me, personally, being single. Pink's my favourite colour. But if those other Tauruses out there, just know that, you know, there's self-love around. There is the need to have unconditional love in your life at the moment. And the carnation brings a very delicate flower, so you might be feeling very delicate at the moment. You could be feeling a little bit vulnerable and needing a little bit more time to love yourself and to take that self-love back within, you know, practice what you think. But with the words healing, strength and courage, take those words this month, Taurus, for your God, have that healing, have that strength and that respite and that courage to come back and speak the truth and have that abundance with it. Now, what shall we see from old, it's another earthy card. So, the Queen of Autumn comes up here. Now, this card is about being very practical with situations. It's saying, act with dignity in all situations, be gracious, be practical. You've got the ability to make more contacts around you this month, Taurus. You've got the ability to make practical choices, practical decisions, particularly around working environments or home environments here. It's talking about meeting somebody who could be a fellow Earth sign, so a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, and they'll be coming in to help you, they'll be coming in to support you, give you advice, or give you emotional support, mental support, whatever it is. But it's an excellent card, Queen of Autumn. It indicates that you're getting on top of your finances, that there's a lot of security around you. And Taurus, if you're feeling a bit fragile at the moment, it is going to be your security that's locked. Don't really like change so much, or change that you're not in control of. So you might be finding things a little bit tough as you move into June. But as you come to the end of June, you should be feeling a lot more comfortable, a lot more on top of things. I don't want to say get in your own way, but I want to say that you'll be feeling a lot more confident about everything that is going on around you, and a lot more self-assured there. And all of those cards are talking, you know, if you move towards the end, they're all talking about getting back on track with things and being a lot more secure and independent. So take that soft energy, that love, that healing, that courage, that strength that comes from these cards. And take that respite if you can, Taurus, because you will come back fully armed, fully strong to be able to tackle anything there. Alright? So, have a good month, Taurus. Hope that makes sense. Hope you enjoy those little cards. Carry on following me, Mystic Kate May, Modern Day Mystic, or if you want to see my other website, Mystic River Lounge, and my personal website, www.katemay.co.uk. Thank you very much. Have a good month.